Thank you. You send your stamp of Yvonne of the Western Valley, flower lights, you bring joy and peace, justice, mercy and love. Lord, bless all who look upon this mantra. May it remind us of the humble birth of Jesus and raise up our thoughts to Him, who is God with us, the Savior of all, and who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Let us pray. O God, who bless us, hear God as we wait in the Lord.
for our redemption. Grant it to us as we pray to be welcome, you know this family of the Son, as our Redeemer. We may also merit to face him confidently when he comes again as our child. Who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Thank you.
whom Paul reached Antioch in Pisidia, and entered the synagogue. He stood up, motioned with his hand, and said, "Fellow Israelites, and you others who are God-fearing, listen. The God of this people, Israel, chose our ancestors and exalted the people during their sojourn in the land of Egypt. With uplifted arm, he led them out of it. Then he removed Saul and raised up David as king. Of him he testified, 'I have found David, son of Jesse, a man after my own heart. He will carry out my every wish.' From this man's descendants, God, according to his promise, has brought to Israel a Savior, Jesus. John heralded his coming by proclaiming a baptism of repentance to all the people of Israel. And as John was completing his course, he would say, 'What do you suppose that I am? I am not he. Behold, one is coming after me. I am not worthy to unfasten the sandals of his feet.'" The word of the Lord.
Of her, this one Jesus, who is called the Christ. The total number of generations from Abraham to David is 14 generations from David to the Babylonian exile. 14 generations from the Babylonian exile to the Christ. 14 generations. Now this is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. When his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found a child through the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her husband, since he was a righteous man, yet unwilling to expose her to shame, decided to divorce her quietly. Such was his intention when, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary, your wife, into your home. For it is through the Holy Spirit that this child will be conceived in her. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet. Behold, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke, he did as the angel of the Lord had commanded him, and took his wife into his home. He had no relations with her until the son was born, and he named him Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now that that's over, Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas!
It's Christmas for sure. It's Christmas, 2011. What happened? In so many ways, Christmas 2010 seems to have happened just a week ago. And yet, in other ways, Christmas 2010 seems to have happened so long ago. And yes, the happenings of this past year determines where we are at this Christmas evening. The Christmas season is a unique time of the year. There's no other celebration during the year that is quite like it. For most of us, it is a happy time that centers on God, love, friendliness, family, cousins, aunts, uncles, and yes, tonight, for some of us, it is bittersweet. As we think back to the happenings of this past year, and a tear does fall onto our cheek, remembering loved ones who have passed, difficult situations that existed or even continues to exist, poor health and health that we're worried about, and any dilemma that bears heavy on our hearts, we take with us into Christmas. But it is Christmas. And the dominant theme of Christmas is love and mercy, the love of God for man that calls us out of our response to him. For God's love for us is so great that he became a little baby in Bethlehem 2011 years ago, born of the Virgin Mary and protected by St. Joseph, his foster father. Why did God the Father do this? Become man? He did it from love, to save us from sin and death, and to offer us eternal life and happiness by believing in him, living a just and moral life, to forgive sins, to give eternal life is something only God can do. And that is what Jesus Christ came into this world to do, for all mankind, for you, and yes, for me. I know you believe that, because otherwise you would not be here on this day. So to our visitors, the most important person here welcomes you. His name is Jesus the Christ. Welcome. Of course, you have welcomes from our pastor, Father George, who is our celebrant, Father Tadeusz, Deacon John, myself, those who know me, don't know me, Deacon Bob, our staff, and indeed all of our parish family. And to you then, our parish family, our continual prayers for a truly blessed Christmas. Yes, it's Christmas. Christmas once again, no matter what. In good times and bad, each year, Christians celebrate Christmas. It is the time that we give gifts to each other. Our giving gifts is symbolic of God's gift to all of us. God the Father has given us a special gift. He's given us His Son. His gift of His Son, Jesus of Nazareth, who is a human being just like us, born of a human mother, but at the same time, He is God Almighty, creator of the heavens and the earth. So God, who is spirit and invisible to human eyes in Jesus, became visible, located in time and space, in Israel, over 2,000 years ago. Jesus is both human and divine. He has a human nature, taken from His mother Mary. But He is not a human person, we know that. He's a divine person. St. John calls Him the Word made flesh, the second person of the Blessed Trinity. This is a great mystery, and can be affirmed only in the light of faith. And faith, your faith, comes before you this day to be analyzed as to where are you with God this Christmas. Each and every Christmas is asked, where are you this Christmas? Most of us here this day are regular Sunday Catholics. And whether you come each Sunday to Holy Mass, and notice I call it Holy Mass, for it is the finest of things you can do that are holy. Many come each week because it's obligatory, a must-do if you're Roman Catholic. Others come to Holy Mass each Sunday, and yes, some come even each day, for they wish to start each day in prayer. Usually prayers of thanksgiving for all that God gives us, but also included are prayers of petition. That poem we used to call those beginning prayers. Lord, give me this, and Lord, give me that, and give me another thing. Sounds like a Bronx-like talk, right? I see some of the New Yorkers laughing. And yes, prayers of praise, for having the gift of faith, which is given to all, and not accepted by some. On Christmas, we are called to gift ourselves. You are called to give a gift to yourself, not a New Year's resolution type of gift that you lose in a few days. No, a Christmas gift like no other gift. Are you on your prayer list? Are you on your gift list? Think about it. The gift of faith is probably the greatest gift you can be given. Ask those with faith who come to adore the Lord every Sunday and to some every day, and they'll tell you, faith changes your life, always for the better. I want to say that again. Faith changes your life, always for the better. It makes, as Bishop Fulton Sheen always said, it makes life worth living. To receive this great gift, you must ask for it every day. And yes, you will receive it every day. And yes, it will grow and make you a much better person. With faith, your life changes. It's true that with faith in God, you can do anything. You can face anything. Will you always be happy if you have faith? Let me answer that question by the words our Blessed Mother said in one of her apparitions to St. Bernadette of Lourdes. Her exact words to Bernadette was, Bernadette, I cannot promise you happiness in this world, only in the next. That's the promise that we all have. She would say that to each of us. And you know what? That's good enough for me, for sure. So how do you get faith? It's simple to do. Just say to Almighty God before you leave here tonight, give me faith to believe and the hope that comes with it. And then ask Him every day, give me faith to believe and the hope that comes with it. And most especially on His birthday. For a faith-filled person who lives in hope lives differently. Ask for faith every day, and each day will be lived as if it were Christmas. As believers of Christ, we have the hope of everlasting life. Through our baptism, he has cleansed us from sin, and by his grace has made us children of God. For those who fall into serious sin because of weakness, he also gave us the sacrament of penance, by which one recovers the state of sanctifying grace. Together, when we look at that manger and consider who Jesus is, God the man, surrounded by Mary and Joseph, by the shepherds and animals, we should rejoice and thank God for this great gift and adore him from the bottom of our hearts, just as Mary, Joseph, and the shepherd did. May God bless you, and may you enjoy a happy and holy Christmas with your family and friends. And may each of us be touched with a deeper gift of faith on this very day. So many people in the back said to me, well, Deacon Bob, are you going to sing the song you sang to us last week at this mass? And I said, I wasn't planning on, and some people asked for it, so I'm going to do three or four lines. But it's everything that Christmas is about. Listen to the words. It's a beautiful song. It goes like this. And the Lord said, Merry Christmas. I want you all to know I've given you a special gift because I love you so. I tried to think of something I could give to everyone. I've given you my special gift. I've given you my son. Merry Christmas. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
To our church, the family of God gathered together on this Christmas Eve, that we will allow the child Jesus into our hearts to strengthen our bonds of love for one another and illuminate our lives together. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an openness to the incarnation of our lives that may allow the Word to become flesh through our deeds of kindness and compassion in the truth which we speak, and our willingness to be present with one another, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all who are traveling or away from home this night, especially members of the military, that God will guide their moments, their movements, preserve them in love, and bring them home safely, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who find the season difficult, for the lonely, the sick, and the poor, the unemployed, may the commemoration of the birth of Christ give them hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have died recently and in this past year, let's include our loved ones and fellow parishioners. The power of Christ's birth on earth may be born in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
All of the many, many intentions that are in our prayer book in place there each and every day. And any intentions that we brought to the altar this afternoon, this evening. Let us pray to the Lord.
Joy, God, cry out.
Blessed are you, O God of all creation, for through your goodness you have received that divine and your presence, through the divine word of your mouth, it will become our spirit, Father. Saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Thank you.
for the queen to take away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I come to you.
Thank you. Our community song is number 91, Silent Night, 91.
Thank you.
that it is, they become the sacramental sign of your son's union with the church as his spouse. Look with favor on Thomas and George, whom you have united in marriage, as they ask for your help in the protection of the Virgin Mary. They pray that in good times and in bad, they will grow in love for each other, that they will resolve to be one of us in the God of peace. Lord, in their struggles, let them rejoice that you are here to help them. In their need, let them know that you are there to rescue them. In their joys, let them see that you are the source and completion of every happiness. We ask this to Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Dear Thomas and Jude, accept our wishes, not only the anniversary of vision, but also Christmas. May God protect and bless you for every other day. God bless you. Congratulations.
Our closing hymn is number 82, Joy to the World.